Ok, chicos, buenos días. ¿Cómo están?
Fine, teacher. Very well.
Okay, great. Okay, guys, today is our 13th session, and this session is about questions or exclamations, okay? And I would like to speak about the final exam. I'm going to speak about in Spanish. Well, okay, guys, el examen final es la próxima semana, como ustedes bien saben, el martes 7 de mayo, si mal no estoy. Chicos, el examen final les voy adelantando de una vez. Va a ser una entrevista, va a ser una entrevista individual. ¿Listo? O sea, no los voy a reunir en grupo, sino que los voy a ir llamando a cada uno. Okay, pero ese día les explico la metodología del examen, pero va a ser una entrevista. Los temas que vamos a ver durante esta semana son pieza fundamental del examen. ¿Listo? Entonces, para que lo tengan muy en cuenta, para los que me estaban pidiendo como que les dijera los temas o de lo que se iba a tratar el examen. Les adelanto, es una entrevista. En relación a todo lo que hemos visto, sí, vamos a enfatizar, pero en especial esta semana quiero enfatizar en ciertos temas que van a ser parte fundamental de la entrevista. ¿De acuerdo, muchachos? Ah, ¿de acuerdo, chicos?
Sí, teacher.
Yes, teacher.
Ok.
Yeah.
Ok, wow. I'm going to show you a picture. Please wait a minute. Okay.
Che, rápidamente, el puntaje, una preguntita ahí rápida. El puntaje total de todo los speaking, ¿cuánto es? ¿Cuánto es el puntaje de todo?
Nosotros no tenemos conocimiento de eso. Nosotros los calificamos sobre 20 a ustedes, pero el total lo tiene el curso de ustedes como tal. Por ejemplo, este examen final a ustedes les vale 20.
20 puntos, el solo examen final.
El solo examen final.
Y el proceso que se ha hecho no tiene puntaje, ¿o sí?
No sé si ustedes ya les entregaron un ponderado de calificaciones, porque ya de hecho pasamos unas calificaciones respecto a ustedes. No sé si ya se les entregaron como ese resultado, que es sobre 20.
Si de pronto me entregaron, yo no he visto, no he visto.
Ok. Nosotros no sabemos como tal cuántos puntos son. Nosotros los calificamos sobre 20, digamos, cada cierto tiempo, pero no sabemos eso cuánto suma en el curso de ustedes como tal. Ok.
Sí, señora. Sí, es que preciso esta vez cambio porque en la pasada sí me acuerdo que aparecían 80 puntos, era el total completo
Y
listo.
creo que lo son en la suma de
Ah,
todo.
eso. Eso, deben ser 80 puntos por ahí. Pasa que la vez pasada en la agenda ahí le aparecía unos 80 puntos. Esta vez no apareció, entonces queda uno. Sí, por ahí veo los 20 puntos del examen, por ahí le.
Okay. Well, vamos a comenzar, ¿de acuerdo? Gonzalo, I have a question for you.
Okay.
Have you ever feel excited or angry? And why?
Yes, it's normal. Sometimes you feel angry or excited. For example, you feel excited when your birthday, when you receive an special invitation in your home. Yes, and when you receive a gift, yes, that you like so much. And when you feel angry, ¿cierto? Angry, you feel angry. I sometimes I feel angry, but in in a few I forgot the vocabulary.
Better.
Okay. No, maybe in the past when a girlfriend, I feel angry. But in another aspect, no, I don't feel angry. I am a relaxed person. I am simple. Yes. I don't complicate with my life with other people. But my girlfriend, sometimes in the past I felt angry in the past.
With your girlfriend or ex-girlfriend?
No, it's girlfriend. It's girlfriend. In this moment, I am single.
Okay.
Women are so complicated.
Okay. That happens.
It depends. Yeah, obviously, it depends on the women, on the woman.
Okay, right. Can you explain that in Spanish for us?
Lo primero que comenté es que pues uno se siente sí, excited, feliz, contento, sí, es cuando uno recibe una persona especial un cumple, en el cumpleaños o cuando uno recibe un regalo que le gusta mucho. Y cuando me sentía en el pasado hablaba de, sí, de exnovias, de resto yo no me complico la vida, o sea, yo no, yo soy una persona ca calmada y relajada, o sea, sí, yo no le presto atención a enojarme así por cualquier cosa, por otro, ¿sí? Obviamente, me pongo bravo por la injusticia, bueno, eso no lo dije en inglés, del país y de la gente, que sea cinética. Pero el resto, no, no, o sea, porque el estrés, mire, todo eso no lo dije en inglés, bueno, pero ahí se nos extiende. Me refiero a que el estrés desgasta mucho a una persona, entonces entre menos estrés tenga usted, menos usted se enferma y más años vive y mejor. ¿Okay? Bueno, eso no lo dije en inglés.
Okay, I understand your point of view regarding that, and I want to ask you other questions. How do you show your emotions?
Can you repeat again the question, teacher?
How do you show your emotions?
Sí, ¿cómo muestro mis emociones, cierto?
Well, but in English, please.
But it depends, ¿no? For example, yes, I can see, I can see the picture, happy, like I said in another questions, when you receive a gift, when you get a special day, a special meeting. And it depends, teacher. Different dimension, it depends on the day because every day, the person, for example, today you are good, you are in a good condition, yes, about your health. But for example, tomorrow, yes, you can get sick, yes. And you can control that, you can control it, okay?
Control it. Okay.
Okay.
That's all.
Yes, teacher.
Can you explain that in Spanish? What is going on? Something is wrong.
Yes, I have to open the door, teacher. So go on.
Well, can you explain that in Spanish for us, your last answer, please?
Que bueno, ahí me demoré en responder porque usted me decía, sí, que cómo demuestro mis emociones, pues eso depende, ¿no? O sea, eso depende del día, porque todos los días, por ejemplo, uno todos los días no está igual, ¿no? Porque uno no es un robot, uno no es, bueno, eso tampoco lo en inglés, uno no es una máquina. Entonces, como hoy usted puede estar bien, ¿sí? Por ejemplo, mañana usted puede amanecer enfermo. Bueno, ¿sí? Eso fue básicamente lo que dije, ¿sí? Eso depende de las emociones, eso es Eso depende mucho de la persona.
Well, Gonzalo, thank you very much. Please close your microphone. María Paula, come here.
Yes, teacher.
María Paula, tell me, have you ever feel excited or angry and why?
Yes, teacher, obviously. I feel excited, for example, when I go to some place that I like, or when I spend time with a special person for me, or with my family, or my friends. And I feel angry when, well, this aspect depend of the no sé, how do you say temperamento of the person. And some people is more I don't know the word irritable than another. But personally, I feel angry when someone do something that I don't like, or when, no, I think when someone do something that I don't like, basically. No more. I think that it doesn't exist another situation for being angry. I don't know.
Well, when you say temperamental, can be character. It's like something like that. And when you say irritable, it can be angry. Yeah, it's like that, okay? Well, can you explain that in Spanish for us?
Yo me siento feliz, emocionada cuando, por ejemplo, estoy en algún lugar que me gusta mucho o que comparto tiempo con alguien especial, como mi familia o mis amigos, y me pongo de mal genio. Decía que hay personas que eso depende como del temperamento de la persona, porque hay personas que son más mal geniadas o irritables que otras, pero personalmente me pongo de mal genio, no sé, cuando alguien hace algo que no me gusta o pues algo así.
Well, okay. How do you show your emotions?
Maybe with when I'm excited, I smile. Yeah, I don't know. I laughed. So I express with my face. The same when I am angry, I express that with my face, with my expression in my face.
Okay. Can you explain that in Spanish for us, please?
Cómo expreso mis emociones cuando estoy emocionado, cuando estoy de mal genio, pues las expreso con mi cara. Por ejemplo, cuando estoy feliz, pues sonrío, me río. Y cuando estoy de mal genio, pues también lo expreso con mi cara. Entonces la gente puede notar que efectivamente estoy de mal genio.
Okay. Thank you very much, María Paula. Close your microphone. Juan Camilo, come here, please. Juan Camilo, are you here? Guys, somebody knows something about Juan Camilo?
No, teacher, I don't know what happened with Juan Camilo.
Juan Camilo is here, but... Okay, wait a minute, please. Where is Juan Air? I can see. Can you hear me and see me?
Yes, teacher.
Yes, teacher.
Okay. Well, the next exercise, I'm going to close this. Wait a minute, please. Juan Camilo, are you here? I can hear you. Your microphone is inactivated now. Juan? Okay, Juan Camilo. Juan Camilo, can you hear me?
He's speaking.
Yeah, he's speaking, but okay. Guys, the next exercise is very, very easy. You're going to make a list regarding emotions, okay? The good and bad emotions. For this exercise, I'm going to give you 5 minutes. Well, and you're going to show me your list. Are you understand that? Yes?
Raya, Liz, with
yes, teacher.
Different emotions. Yep. Yes?
Yes. Okay.
Ya, profe.
Good and bad emotions, okay?
And we have Hola. To explain, obviously, we have to explain every word.
Sorry?
For example, I write 10 emotions and I have to explain every emotion, the meaning.
No, it's no? not necessary. You only write, okay? Good and bad emotions. Please close your microphone in camera, and Maria Paula, close your microphone in camera. Juan Camilo, can you hear me?
Sí, profe.
Juan Camilo, your partner is making an exercise regarding the class, and I'm going to ask you some questions, okay?
Okay.
Juan Camilo, have you ever feel excited or angry, and why?
¿Por qué me pongo triste o feliz? ¿Triste o enojado?
It's similar, but have you ever feel something in your life?
Oh, yes, teacher, I have feeling. For example, when I play basketball and my team loser, I am very hungry.
And excited, for example.
What?
Have you ever feel excited? Happy?
Yes.
Maybe.
Ah, happy?
Yes.
Happy or excited, for example, when my mother cooking a delicious food, rice with chicken, I am very happy because the food is in my favorite food and this is very delicious.
Well, can you explain that in Spanish for me?
Okay, teacher, tell me in Spanish. Por ejemplo, me pongo enojado cuando estoy jugando baloncesto y mi equipo pierde, ¿sí? Entonces, no. Pues siempre acostumbramos a ganar, pero pues es muy raro cuando perdemos. Entonces, la mayoría nos ponemos, en vez de triste, nos das como rabia. Y cuando me pongo feliz o emocionado, cuando mi mamá, por ejemplo, cocina arroz con pollo, sí. De hecho, es una de mis comidas favoritas, entonces me gusta mucho. Y además de que ella cocina muy rico.
Well, nice. The next question is, How do you show your emotions?
¿Cómo demuestras las emociones?
Yes.
Okay.
In English.
How do you show an emotion? For example, many people demonstrate emotion show the face, but so is the most of the actions. For example, very hungry is I see very bad for people. For example, when I'm hungry, I look bad at my mother or my father.
When you're hungry or angry?
Angry.
But hungry is like hambriento. Angry is enojado.
Angry.
Okay. Can you explain that in Spanish for me?
Me pongo, por ejemplo, muchas personas demuestran sus emociones mediante el rostro, así mediante expresiones faciales. Pero pues yo también lo hago, por ejemplo, mediante acciones. Por ejemplo, cuando me pongo, me enojo, una manera de mostrarlo en mí es mirando mal a las personas, mirándolas muy mal.
Okay. Well, thank you very much, Juan Camilo. Now, you're going to make a list, okay? With good emotions and bad emotions. Are you understanding?
Yes, teacher. I list good emotions and bad emotions.
Yes.
And explain?
No. It's not necessary.
Okay.
Okay, I'm going to give you 3 minutes only, okay? Okay, close your microphone, dear. Guys, are you ready?
Yes, teacher, I am finished.
Okay, are you ready?
No, teacher. No.
No?
No, un minuto.
Oh, Gonzalo. ¿De
cuánto era la lista? ¿De cuánto era la lista exactamente, profe?
50.
Don't matter the number. Okay, but okay. I'm going to give 1 minute to Maria Paula, okay? Let's wait for her. Okay, guys, time is over, okay? Please open your cameras and microphones. Please, Gonzalo, you are the first. Come on. Gonzalo, are you here?
Yes, Happy? Happy?
Okay, good. Okay, good emotions. Speak me about your list of your good emotions.
Okay, I wrote happy, calm, surprise, interest, and satisfied, and no more. I grow more negative emotions. Scared. I grow sleepy. Sleepy is right, or is wrong?
If you consider that it is a good emotion, yes. That's okay.
Today I feel so sleepy. Today for that reason. Angry, nervous, sad, confused, anxious. Or that's it. That's those my emotions today.
Thank you, Gonzalo. Close your microphone.
Okay.
Maria Paula, speak me about your good and bad emotions, please.
Good emotions, happiness, emotion, calm, surprise, pleasure, tranquility, trust, grateful and pride. And bad emotions, anger, nuisance, stress, depression, anxiety, concern, sadness, fear, and boredom.
Thank you, Maria Paula. Juan Camilo, open your camera and speak me about good and bad emotions, please.
Okay, teacher, good emotion. Gratitude, surprise, pleasing, joy, interest, hope, satisfaction, euphoria, happy. But emotion is fear, anger, is good, surprise, but surprise in this case is preparing for something bad. Sadness, frustrating, depression, envy, alarmed, scary.
Well, thank you, Juan Camilo. The next exercise is a group exercise, okay? You're going to write 10 sentences of exclamation, okay? Expressing emotions in these phrases, okay? 10 sentences, don't forget that. This is a group exercise, and I'm going to give 12 minutes for this. Okay, guys, are you understand?
Yeah, teacher, but the sentence is about the any emotions?
Yeah, can be, for example, one sentence is regarding angry, other regarding happy, or regarding falling in love, for example. I don't know.
Okay.
This isn't a group exercise, okay? And I'm going to give you guys 12 minutes for this. Well?
Yes, I understand.
Well, guys, see you in 12 minutes.
Por ejemplo, una oración con frustración, un amor imposible.
Frustrated. Amor, ¿ha tenido amor imposible con Camilo?
¿Qué no. Tuvo amor?
No.
Impossible, no. Love. ¿Qué es esa vaina? ¿Y usted, Gonzalo?
No sabe dónde se mete también.
¿Sí o no? For example, I very, very sad because my girlfriend is in other country.
Sí, como ese grupo, imagino, we have to write.
Sí.
For example, I wrote 4 and you write 3 and María Paula write 3, ¿no?
Ah, ok.
Yes, I. Porque si lo haríamos cada uno, every. ¿Sí? If you pass the right 10, pues it's an activity, it's an individual activity, no?
Exactly.
Si no, le hacemos trampa y a la profe. So, entonces,
por ejemplo,
para no repetirnos de pronto las emociones, no repetirlas, ok? Don't repeat.
For example, I choose. Sadness.
Yo tengo una con excited.
Ah, okay.
Y de hecho so, más. Entonces ya siga eligiendo.
In one sentence, I choose two emotions, sad and frustrated. Sorry.
Okay. You choose sad and frustrated, and one more.
You choose this is emotion?
No, okay. O sea, falta una, ¿eh? Una más.
Okay, understand.
Sad, frustrated, and the last one. What is the last?
Okay.
Yo tengo excited, fear, y no sé.
Yo estaba a punto de decir fear.
Y estrés ya está, ¿no?
¿Cuál?
Estrés.
Ok.
Tenía algo de religión.
I choose admiration.
Yeah.
Una pregunta, ¿cómo se dice huérfano en inglés?
Lo que es orfan. Orfan, do you remember or have you ever watched, have you ever seen that movie? La huérfana? Or
orfan.
Yes, orfan. Orfan.
Guys, I choose emotion euphoria. I feel in euphoria because the movie Avengers.
Avengers? What happened with the movie?
Okay.
You want to tell us a spoiler, Camilo?
No. I see that I know Jiva spoiler. You see the movie?
No, I haven't seen the movie yet.
Ah, okay.
Yes, maybe the next week. Maybe next week I went to watch.
Ah, okay, understand. Yeah. I tengo un amigo que sí, verdad, es muy fan de eso y se mandó a hacer una camisa y todo para el de la película.
Yes, in Popayán, many people went to the cinema on costume. Yes, she dressed se fueron disfrazados, mejor dicho.
Por ahí que mire que le dieron una paliza a un joven por dar spoilers, por poner dar spoilers, en pleno cine.
Sí, hay gente que toma eso muy a pecho y se vuelve, es complicado. Sí, el fanatismo, lo que hace el fanatismo, Juan Camilo. Sí, obviamente, claro, uno le molesta que no me cuente la película, pero no, llegar a la gente a ese extremo, no. Sino que hay gente ya que lo hace es por jodido, o sea, que ponen ahí a contar la película.
Sí, y hay otros, que no se la aguantan y lo terminan golpeando.
Sí. Bueno, por redes sociales, por ahí, un amigo ya visto ahí delatando la película, hermano. Yo ni le dije nada por no, que ya hace cuánto no hablo con el huevón, pero nada.
Me puse a ver en YouTube y ya subieron prácticamente todas las partes importantes de la película.
Guys, sorry, but you are filming now in other words is...
Llegó Capitana Marvel, Juan Camilo.
Okay. No. It's true. Really. In these videos I put on YouTube.
Ah, okay.
Okay, guys, thank you very much. Are you finished?
Are you Capitana Marvel, teacher, or what are you?
I'm a simple person. Okay.
Teacher, I am finished.
But it is a group exercise, you know?
Yes,
teacher.
I'm finished. Ready?
Okay, guys, please open your cameras.
Okay.
Guys, wait a minute, please. Guys, can you see my pictures?
Yes.
Really?
Yeah. Yes, I can.
Can you see this?
Yes, teacher, I can see the picture.
This brain, you can see?
Yes.
Jordan. Oh, that's great. Okay. Guys, please, come on. I want to hear you, but I want to hear and see the expressions. If you are happy, okay, I want to see. If you are sad, yes, I want to see. I want to see your emotions in this representation of the sentences.
Representation, the emotion, teacher?
Yeah. For example, oh man, I'm very sad. I'm very sad because, I don't know, my boyfriend is in another country. You know, it's something like that.
Okay, I am going to win the Oscar.
Yeah, you're going to win the Oscar. Come on. Who is the first one?
Okay, no, I finished my painting. Yes, and so I am important painter, no? And I feel satisfied. Yes?
Yeah.
Yes.
Who is the next?
Today I feel so sleepy. You saw my emotion previously, because last night I have to study much. Yes, and it is true. I feel so sleepy. And the last one is, it is my first day at work, and I feel a little nervous, but it is normal. It happens.
Who is the next? Or nobody?
I teacher.
Mm-hmm. Moin.
Okay. I'm feeling admiration by my friend Pedro because he is orphan. Even so, he is a teacher from the university.
Mm-hmm.
The second sentence is the emotion sad and frustrating. I'm very sad and frustrated because my love is in other country.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah. Okay.
He's a liar. And the last is euphoria. I am feeling euphoria by seeing the movie Avengers Endgame.
Euphoria or euphoric?
Euphoria.
You're euphoric. Okay.
Okay, teacher, no, sorry.
No problem. Okay, great. Who's the next? You are the next, Maria Paula, right?
Yeah. I feel excited when my mom comes to visit me. Last night we saw a terror movie and then I felt fear and I couldn't sleep alone. When I have to do something quickly, I feel stressed. And the last one is, I was very proud for my friend's graduation.
Great. Thank you very much, guys. I really love it. Okay, wait a minute, please. Well, the next exercise is a very, very good exercise for you. Give me a second, please. I like the stories, and I like when you write some story for me. Well, Please write one paragraph regarding some story with an special emotion. For example, 2 years ago, I'm falling in love of a very good boy or very good girl, and I'm feeling blah, blah, blah. I don't know. This is an example, okay? I'm going to give you for this just 10 minutes, and I want to hear very good stories, okay, guys?
Because teacher, I have a question.
Sorry.
Is in group now?
Individual.
Okay, individual. Okay, teacher.
Okay, yes. Gonzalo, please be happy. Come on, you are born. I feel I see you born. No, 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 no. Don't lie for me, okay?
Very sleepy, and in the morning, I wanted to go to run.
Well,
so I feel tired too.
You can write the paragraph, the story regarding your
life. I ran 1 hour, teacher. Don't stop.
Well, I know, but you are. I don't know. You are relaxed right now.
Yes, I ran 1 hour.
Well, please write the paragraph, and I see you. I'm going to see you in 10 minutes, right?
Okay, teacher.
Guys, are you ready?
No, teacher, give me 2 minutes, please.
Gonzalo, are you ready?
Oh, teacher, no. Now I'm finished.
2 minutes more.
Teacher, I am preparing a wonderful history.
Okay, guys, time is over. Please, María Paula, you are the first one. Open your camera, please.
Some years ago, I traveled to San Andres Island with my friends. It was a wonderful trip. And before the trip, I felt nervous and excited, and I couldn't sleep very well. But then when I was there, it was awesome. We had a very funny moment, and we was so happy and fun. We knew some places and people, and in general, it was an amazing trip.
Okay, that's all, Maria?
Yes, teacher, that's all.
Gonzalo, come on.
Yes, teacher.
Come on. What's the story?
No, teacher, I didn't write the story. I didn't write anything.
Really?
Yes, no, I didn't the exercise.
Why?
I feel tired, teacher. I didn't do it.
Are you really? Really? Seriously?
Yes. I searched in internet for a story, but obviously that's not my word. I didn't try anything.
Okay, but you can speak about it?
About the topic? No, I didn't exercise, no.
No. Can you speak about, for example, I don't know.
The reason?
No. I'm really surprised, but no, I want to know something, story regarding your life and regarding your emotions, maybe.
For example, I could say in the past, I feel so sad because my dad died 20 years ago. I could say that, yes?
Mm-hmm. That's all?
Yes.
Juan Camilo, come here and tell me your story, your creation, please.
Okay, teacher, my history is 5 years ago, I was very excited to learn to play basketball. I knew nothing, but I wanted to learn a lot, even so I started to go besides that. I go to at 4 a.m. to train when I would a friend, a gym, for 1 year. That time is well, very good playing basketball, and the coach took me at the departmental level. Thanks to all, we won. Or it was the first time winner. It was one of the best moments for my life, because in this moment, I feel that we have won by the effort my beat each one. This moment was perfect for me. I was wonderful by the victory.
Okay, victory? You mean victory something?
Exactly.
Well, thank you very much. Wait a minute, guys, dear guys. Wait a minute more. What is going on with this? I don't know. Okay, no problem, doesn't matter. Well, guys, our season is over right now. But I want to know something. Maria Paula, what do you think about the activity?
Um, I think it's a good activity because we can learn more vocabulary, especially with about the emotions. I like these activities for that reason.
Thank you, Maria Paula. Gonzalo, what do you think about the activity?
Yes, teacher, the activity is good.
I need to speak with you at the end, okay?
Okay.
Yeah, with you.
Okay, okay.
Juan Camilo, come here. Juanel.
One moment. Yes, teacher.
Okay. What do you think about the activity?
This activity was very simple because normally the people is expressing your emotions.
Their emotions.
Emotion by the face or the action. In this session was simple. For me, the more part was expressing for my face the emotion with the sentence.
Okay. Cuando tú hablas de la gente y que quieren mostrar sus emociones, es básicamente their emotions.
Their emotion. Ah, okay. They. O sea, refiriéndose a ellos.
Yes. Okay, thank you very much. Okay, guys, our session is over and I would like to give you some general opinions, okay? Como siempre, se llevó muy bien a cabo la actividad, se cumplieron los propósitos. María Paula, buen desarrollo de la actividad. Te recomiendo práctica de vocabulario un poco, pero en términos generales muy bien. Te felicito mucho.
Thank you, teacher.
Juan Camilo, buen desarrollo de la actividad, has dado buenos avances, me gusta el ánimo que le imprimes a las cosas y te defiendes y bueno, en fin, me gusta eso, he visto un buen avance, sigo recomendando práctica, bueno, vocabulario, oral grammar, ok, connectors, please. Gonzalo, buen desarrollo de la actividad, te noté un poco, no sé cómo decirlo, pero bueno, buen desarrollo de la actividad, ¿de acuerdo? Te recomiendo, como siempre, práctica de oral grammar y práctica de vocabulario. Terminando esta llamada, I'm going to call you, ¿ok? Please stay on Skype, ¿right? Are you understand?
Yes.
Okay.
Only Gonzalo, teacher.
Only Gonzalo, because I need to speak with him very, very seriously. No. I need to know something, and I would like to speak with you, okay?
Okay, teacher.
Only Gonzalo.
Bye.
Sorry?
Ah, ya se van. Pensé que ya.
What? No. Okay, guys. Mañana tenemos nuevamente encuentro. Tenemos nuestra 14ª sesión. Entonces, muy pendientes a la misma hora y por el mismo canal. Muchísimas gracias, muchachos. Buen desarrollo de la actividad. And see you tomorrow, okay, guys? Thank you very much. Bye.
Thank you, teacher. Bye-bye.